one for we must primarily matter through comment, not the first comment, because this is the idea from the human brain. So you cannot just the student wrong or just the student
sorry more
Yes.
We now have reached the second step of the constructivism method. So the first step, remember, orientation, yeah. The second step, elicit ideas. Now we will come to the first step. It is called restructure the idea. Why the idea need to be restructured? Because usually student idea or career preconception is wrong. Some of their concept is wrong. So in this step, we have to restructure the student idea. So this is very important step of the constructivism method, because first one, we have to fix the wrong idea from the student, and then we have to teach the new idea. The new idea is actually the idea which is to be learned in the teaching and learning process. So now we will, I will explain to you the third component. Yeah, this component consists of this step consists of four components. The first one is called clarification of idea. So it can be done by question and answer. So student can ask to each other about the idea someone has proposed during the elicit idea. So for instance, someone said about the concept, and the student can verify what do you mean by this concept, what do you mean by that statement. So it is called the clarification. By doing so, a student will sharpen their idea. They will know more about somebody else's idea and give comment based on this idea. That's the first component. The second component is present conflict cognitive phenomena. So at this time, student will be posed with the conflict phenomena. For instance, in terms of inclined plane, remember that to make a car moving forever, it is can be done by just make the plane in plane. So by inclined plane, the car will move forever. So the student idea about to give sand in the floor and to change the floor with the glass, actually it is a wrong idea. The correct idea is to just to make the plane inclined. By inclining plane, and then the car can move forever. That is actually the conflict idea. The idea which is not be taught by the student. Student didn't think it before, so it is called a cognitive conflict idea. And then after that, we comes to the next component. It is called the new idea. This is actually the most important part of the teaching, because this is the time teacher teach the new concept of the lesson. So the new concept of the lesson is coming at this step, which is teaching new idea. And after teaching new idea, the last component is to evaluate whether the concept of the student is correct. So that is the third component. I hope you can understand what I have explained to you. And now your turn to teach your friend.
Okay.
explain three steps of the constructivism, that is orientation step, elicit idea step, and then restructure idea step. Now we will move to the next step of constructivism method. It is called apply the new idea. You know, after students acquire a new concept or new idea from teacher, and teacher have evaluated that the concept is correct already, but it is not enough. Teacher need to know whether student can apply the new concept to a new situation. The key word of the apply new idea is new situation. So teacher should find out a new situation and then ask the student to apply the new concept to the new situation. So that is the fourth concept. So I think you can understand because it is very brief, right? And it's now your turn to teach your parents. Teach!
Okay.